Ready? We're gonna lie on our backs. Alright, this is where the fun and the magic happens. Remember guys, you do the best that you can do, okay? If you need to take a break during the 45 seconds, you do that. Okay, you just take a few breaths, and when you're ready, you jump back in. And that's all it is. You don't have to keep up, okay? You do your best. Ready? We're on in 10. Getting in our position. Remember, a little before you go. Here we go. Up. When the bum is off the floor, it's off the floor for good.
Push out.
exercise is very difficult. So learn the exercise first and then combine it. Make sure the knee stays nice and straight with just a slight supple bend through it. The other foot is in visual sight. Four, three, two, one. Good. Take a little break. Let's take a deep belly breath in. And then exhale, engage the pelvic floor and the inner core. One more time. Inhale, big belly. Exhale, engage. Go onto your opposite leg and off we go. Up and down, up and down. Keeping that leg nice and straight, just with a supple bend in the knee. And remember, when the heel is gone, it's off the floor for the entire duration of the exercise, and you're trying to pulse on an increasing tempo of speed. So up, 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 up. So most of the muscles in the calves are often fast twitch fiber muscles, so they do require a certain element of speed to get them firing up, and you can see how that changes instantly how much you felt that. Yes? All right, let's grab those mats, have a seat on the floor. We got 12 seconds.
Let's get rid of the ball.
apart. Squeeze the ball, push the feet apart. Squeeze the ball, push the feet apart. Squeeze the ball, push the feet apart. Make sure you're holding the squeeze. Make sure you're holding that squeeze. I know it burns, guys. Stay with it. Stay with it. Keep going. Almost there. 15 seconds. The harder you squeeze and the harder you try and push those legs out, the more you're going to get that side wall of the pelvic floor. Try and get a good contraction in there. Squeeze. Good. Now, you get rid of those balls. Bend where they are. Feet go straight up. Get your arms on the inside for help or down. Last three, guys. This is it. Here we go. Pushing out. 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 Out, 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 out. Now, if you're finding this very easy when you practice this one at home, you grab a tension like mine that isn't allowing me to go any further than this because it's so hard, okay? And that's essentially what you want. When you're opening up like Jen is, it's because she's too strong for that one, okay? And that's okay, she's doing the best she can with the resistance she has right now, but at home, she would go up into the resistance.
Symmetrical as possible is important.
two, and one. Beautiful. Well done, guys. You did it. All right. How are we doing? We're good? Did we get warmed up a bit? A little bit? I started sweating a little bit.
I should have minded this turn instead of last year.
You should have waited.
Why? You guys have worked in last year's class. You have never come back. Time's worse.
But see, I listen to the feedback. That's why you guys have to provide me with feedback, because
this
otherwise
was like, this was beginners.
You were at the leg one too, the first one, yeah?
No.
No?
Yeah. Yeah.
No,
not
no, we were at the arms one.
That one's changed. They've all changed. And that's what happens as you develop and you grow. You listen to feedback, you can tell you things, and if it was too hard, then you have to modify it. And you're just going to work it. And then also, the other big thing is I learn, right? I'm always learning. I go to ongoing education courses. I try to get out at least every 2-3 months at most. So I'm always learning new things. So that I keep updating them and doing new things.
I know, I lost my hair.
Okay, so are there any questions at all? Anybody have any questions? Yes?
So on a week basis, say whatever one through 3 or 4 times a week, how do we work this into what we're doing?
Right. So for example, this would be done twice a week. Okay? On alternating days. And I would use something like this personally as a warm-up. It wouldn't be my leg workout. So after this, I'm going to the gym. And I go do a workout. But for some people, that's sufficient, and that's a great little workout. We only did one round. You would do 2 to 3 rounds of this. Okay, so just so that you have an understanding that the first round, we did two. Let's say we call it two. So I would do one more for sure, because that's when you're really gonna start to feel the failure kick in. Okay, and that's like we had mentioned earlier, that failure is when change is gonna happen. So when that muscle gets to a point where it can't keep going anymore, that's the stimulus it needs for growth. Okay, because if you don't hit that point, you just stop at that point, you don't try to push past that burn or that failure point, then you're not going to get any greater change. Does that make sense? Yeah. So 2 to 3 times a week, but 2 certainly, and you can use it as a warm-up to get these areas fired up, especially if you are suffering from pelvic floor dysfunctions. I would highly recommend it as a great way to bring blood flow to that area and make it work with you as opposed to sleep during your workout. Okay. I have incredibly fit women, you know, that think they're super strong, and myself included, right? I thought, I used to compete, and I was very muscular, but then I never thought in a million years that I would have what happened to me, right? So I always kind of chuckle. I'm like, oh, sweetheart, if you only knew. Okay? It's not like that. It's because we are not aware of these muscles. I didn't know that these muscles existed until they fell out of me. Right? I was like, oh, okay, what's going on here? So that's it. So yeah, definitely use it as a warm-up and alternating days, never really back-to-back. The other thing is you're going to feel that delayed onset muscle soreness. Tomorrow morning, you might wake up and be like, oh, I had a leg workout. You activated muscles you haven't worked out in a while. So you're going to feel stiff. That's good. Nothing wrong with that. That's what you want to feel. That's how you know you create a change in the body. Does that make sense? Yeah? Any other questions?
Actually, this was not easy. It was because I worked so hard since the year I met her that
this became easy.
What happens?
This became easy. Yeah, I don't think that this is easy. Again, if we had done another set, then it probably would have been a little bit more challenging. Yeah, but it's just different stuff. And then my focus is really, I had to zoom in onto that pelvic floor. And like I said, as I learn, I'm coming up with new exercises that help you do that. Yeah. And this is all validated from doing this internally. So just in case people here aren't familiar with what to expect at a pelvic floor physio exam, there is an internal component. It's not necessary by any stretch of the imagination. I treat children who have these conditions as well, and it's contraindicated, or we're not allowed to do internal exams unless certain circumstances present. But for the most part, we don't. So we have something called a biofeedback machine, where we put electrodes on the external areas of the pelvic floor. So we just kind of put them, this is called your central peroneal tendon, it's where all the pelvic floor muscles culminate. And so we put 2 electrodes right there. And then we can pick up the image, the intellectual activity of your muscles on screen. So if you're not comfortable, I have some women with for religious beliefs or what have you, they just don't want that, but they're having issues, and so we use those techniques too. So it's never necessary, but certainly it is part of it. And when I have inside line, doing these exercises on the table with the resistance band, you can feel the muscles inside just gripping the fingers. And then all of a sudden you pull off, and then you do one without, and all of a sudden the contraction is significantly stronger because all this blood flow came to the area. Right, which is beautiful for trying to correct prolapse, incontinence, especially with the weakness issues. And it's also nice for the hypertonic conditions, which are the conditions where they have the urgency and the frequency, or they're suffering from the constipation, because again, it's about still bringing blood flow to the area, you just have to learn how to stretch it. And so then there's various stretches, which is unit 4 and 5. Unit 4 is more connective tissue and stretching, unit 5 is the yin yoga, so that's where we really look at releasing the connective tissue and how it allows for the muscles to let go a little bit easier. So that's also a big part of it too for that particular population. Any other questions?
Okay. How far away is your next class?
So there's one tomorrow night.
The same.
But exact same one, yeah. If you go on my website, www.life.ca, pardon me.
Is it May? Your next one? Or next segment?
I'm going to say it's, I don't know if it's that far away. What are we today, March 10th?
Okay.
It might be late April. Just go check on the website.
I'm asking, you said this video would be available to us, but not for a few weeks.
We have to figure
I
it out.
I don't have great.
Yeah, so I have business cards there in front if you want to take it when you're taking your feedback form, and then you can go visit us online, and those workshops will be up there available to you guys, okay? And then just the, also it says sign up for a workshop, so you go, it'll show. Make sure that when you're looking, there's two clinics, okay? There's one out 22 hours from here, and I'm pretty sure you're not going to drive 22 hours for a workshop, and then there's another one for a cancer. Okay, we're going to try to keep the location the same. I do like the location, we just have to keep the cap down so that we don't, it's obviously, we're limited for space, but other than that, yeah, so it's all there, okay? And the other option is book an appointment, and then you can get one-on-one, and then you can learn more, right? So it's just very, the fundamentals, okay? And I'm happy to see you after class if that's something you're interested in. Any more questions? Good? Well, thank you so much for coming out today. I'm really glad that you guys are showing some interest in your health and potentially your recovery. It's been a pleasure instructing you guys. I hope to see you guys all at our future workshops. And please do not get discouraged. If you feel that you're failing, that's a good thing. Just don't give up, okay? Because failure is truly how we succeed, and success is going from failure to failure without loss of enthusiasm. So take that enthusiasm with you, and let it fuel you to get through this and persevere. Okay? Thanks, guys. Have a good night.